Hello, there is Fimpossible Creations, and in this video I will show you new features which came with Look Animator version 2 and set up character as an example. In this tutorial I will use this Rhino Fighter model from this package made by Masking Bulgrimov. Package is very cheap but have very high quality models. And Look Animator, which you can find on the asset store too. Let's get started. After importing Look Animator to the project, let's add it to the main object. First thing we have to do is defining leading bone slash head. New thing in Look Animator version 2 is this button which shows all bones found in skinned mesh renderers. But still we can hit autofine button and check if right bone is selected now. Sometimes bones named head are jaw bones or something, and then look animation would look wrong. Please check this every time. Object to follow is null, so focus point is in default position. This is debug position for look animator's focus point. Let's tell look animator on which object it should look. Let's check what is happening already. So, Rhino is looking at this big onion, and we can analyze this behavior. You see, it's looking very poor, because we're using only one head bone. We can fix it with single clicks. Hit plus in additional spine bones tab to include other bones in look animation. But don't add too much of them. There we added pelvis bone, which is causing whole model to rotate. Let's use only 4 additional bones. With this slider we can adjust how much our bones should rotate. Untoggling this will allow us to do it manually. Check if neck bone is not causing slouch pose, then you can adjust it here. Or check backbone's parameter in corrections tab. Now when we move onion around, you can see that animation looks much better. But when character would look high up or down, you will notice that arms are rotating unnaturally. You can see it better now. Let's fix it with compensation feature. We don't want arms to rotate, so let's put them in a list. We can hit autofind, so algorithm is trying to find arm bones. With compensation set it to the max, it looks like this. Well, it's what we wanted, but it could look better. This value shouldn't be set to the max, but about half. And also add some position compensation, but a bit just to add something like muscle movement or something to the animation. And there we have some helper parameters. If your Unity animator is in animate physics mode, then you should toggle this. If you want to stop look animator when character model is not visible for optimization, you can put your mesh here. Now, tweak animation tab. First parameter is object to follow. With additional offset options, we can use it when we want, for example, look at tip of the onion. Then when it rotates, we're still looking at this point. You have also possibility to control just position or focus point by selecting world position mode. Then you can control rotation speed of look animation. Value to the max is instant rotation. 0 is very slow, but if you ever would need slower rotation, then you can open this tab and make this value lower. Ultra smoothing parameter is adding additional smoothing rotation, so when rotation speed is set even to instant, there's still some smoothing. You can experiment with these parameters to get different results. Look animator amount is just how much look animator motion you want to use. You can use it to smoothly turning off look animator. Now animation behavior. When max distance is set to 0, its features are disabled. When we set its value higher, the new options will pop up. So when target object is out of this range, character will stop looking. Let's switch to 2D distance, so only X and Z axis will be used for computing distance. Well, what to do when target object is flying in and out of this range, so character is going crazy when this object is behaving like that? We can adjust max out distance factor. Now character will stop looking at this object only when it leaves this red range. But when it's out, it will be detected only in the first range. And now focus point can fly around and nothing bad is happening. Let's disable max distance feature and let's adjust stop looking above parameter. So now when focus point is out of these ranges, then character will stop looking. Very simple but useful. Another parameter is look when above. It's mainly for characters with eyes. So, head will start rotating toward target when the range to look at is above this value. There we have some additional parameters. We can define if after some time character should look at object straightforward. So at first it focus only eyes on target, then rotating whole body towards it. With this you can achieve nice natural look behavior. Now hold rotate to opposite until parameter. You can find it very useful. When target object is flying behind character's back, he can go really crazy like that. By using this parameter, we can define when character should start looking to opposite side. Now he will rotate here only if lower angle is needed on other side. Now object can go crazy and nothing bad happens. Let's disable this feature and let's go to targeting tab. Here you can adjust source position of looking. For example, when your character head is here but eyes are higher or somewhere, you can adjust it here. You can also make this source point animated with bone for more precise rotation, but sometimes it can cause some unwanted behavior, so I suggest using static position. There we have parameter called look at position smoother, and it makes focus point transition smoother to new positions. You can follow it on debug gizmos. You can use it to get different effects. Next parameter is change target smoothing. Let's make rotation speed higher to better see this effect. Let's move onion a bit to the side. So when we change targets, head will have to rotate a bit more. Now when we change targets to look at, head rotation is very sudden. Sometimes we would need the rotation speed to be very high. So in this situation, we can fix it by adjusting parameter change target smoothing. When we adjust this, rotation speed will be slower only for a moment when we change target to look at. Now additional motion settings tab. Animation style is defining how rotation acceleration works. Smooth dump is starting fast, then slowing down at the end. Fast LRP is starting very fast and slowing down. Linear rotates toward in constant speed. I suggest using smooth dump. Max rotation speed is limiting how fast acceleration of bone's rotation can get. Let's adjust rotation speed to better visualize it. As you can see, head here goes very fast when rotating to other side. With max rotation speed adjusted, it's better controlled. Now, base rotation compensation parameter. When you have character which is looking at something and rotating left and right like here, you can notice that head needs to be adjusted when object is rotating. You can fix it by using base rotation compensation. Now when we are rotating character, His look rotation is not disturbed. Weights multiplier is just for fun. You can go to zero for additional blending out animations, or bring it up to get strange results. Now limit animation behavior tab. I think it's very responsive. You can see everything in inspector window or on scene gizmos. So with these parameters, we are just limiting how far head can rotate. But we will not finish on just simple clamping. We have two additional parameters. First is elastic range, which is making clamping range look more natural. So when limit range is hitted, head is not just instantly stopping, it's still following a bit, but with range going higher, he is rotating towards target slower. So it looks like character is using some muscle power to still see this object. Now start look elastic range. Character will not look fully towards target until this range is reached. It's nice for characters with eyes. So when object's position not needs head to rotate much, then it's rotated only a bit. When angle is higher, then head is looking straight forward this position. Alright, now additional modules tab. I will not talk about bird mode and eyes module in this tutorial, because it's for other models. But let's focus on nodding transitions. When we change target to look at, we can add some additional motion to the head. With nodding transitions disabled, when we start looking at new objects, head just rotates toward it. But when we add nodding transition, head will do some additional motion. You have to experiment with node axis values, because on each model, axes are reacting in different directions. So I suggest adjusting it in play mode when targets are changing. So now when we change target, you can see that head is doing some additional motion. Let's reverse it, so head will do little node when rotating toward target focus point. So with nodding transitions and without. And now last thing we will focus in this tutorial video. We will go back to character setup tab, but first let me adjust onion position so you will better see what is going on. So in this version of Look Animator, we have possibility to automate weights of bones when look angle is bigger. So enabling big angle automation gives us possibility to adjust bones weights when character is looking far behind. For example, we want to use spine bones only a little when focus point is in front of character, but use different weights when angle is very big. You can notice here that these bones are moving when object is going more behind. I left clamp limiting angles to be smaller so you can better see it. Now we can do similar thing to compensation bones. We can set compensation weights smaller when angle is big to avoid arms from clipping, and compensation value will go back to default when angle is smaller. You can follow weights values in parentheses. So with all of that we can get pretty much complex look animation, but using not too much effort. You have many possibilities to design look animation to your needs with Look Animator version 2. Oh, it looks Shrimpy wants to eat. Okay, I will feed them, and we have to end this tutorial here. Alright, that was all for this tutorial. I hope you liked it and it was useful for you. If you have some questions, please write comments below. Hit a like, subscribe for more, hit bell for notifications about new videos. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Bye bye!